be blessed by the divine. Sometimes we find ourselves in impossible situations, and one wishes to have a prayer that helps during those impossible situations. I find myself in one such situation at this present moment when I am making this video. My dear wife has been diagnosed of breast cancer. And how am I going to manage this? I rely upon my guru, Sri Vedatri Maharishi, and the wonderful prayer that he has taught me for a situation like this. Now, this is a worry that I need to endure, and there is no point in me wasting my life energy on worrying myself. I need to endure it, I need to face it squarely, and I need to see that I can do what I can to help her overcome this problem, heal herself, and live with good health, long life, enough wealth, peace, prosperity, fame, and wisdom, and peace. Now, in order to do that, I need to depend on this beautiful prayer that our Guru Sri Vedatri Maharishi has taught me. And it contains only two words, and that's the miracle of this prayer. Even a child will be able to say this, and it doesn't have to make you sit down in a place, close your eyes and do this. You can do it at any time, you can do it in any place, and you can do it while you are doing any other work. And the two words are both in Tamil, my mother tongue, and also a translated version that Swamiji has given us in English. I will first say the Tamil one and explain to you, and then I will also tell you the English one and explain the logic and the science behind it. Before I give you this prayer, let me also tell you what is a prayer. A prayer in most acceptable form is a set of words that we recite, perhaps a mantra, perhaps just a chanting. Perhaps it doesn't have any mantra or chanting, but it's just our wish. It's something that we look forward to. It's something that we aim for. It's something that we sometimes don't even aim for it. We just leave it as a voice that can be heard from this by this almighty force, and perhaps not even expecting anything from it. But whatever it may be, a prayer is usually a sound. A sound is a wave. Sometimes the prayer can be in silence, in which case the prayer is a mere thought force. A thought force is also a wave. What happens to a wave, whether it is a sound or whether it is a thought, like in any other wave form, whether it is a light wave or a sound wave or any other wave, these waves first travel and it goes and clashes on the object of contact. A part of the wave reflects, a part of the wave refracts, a part of the wave penetrates, and a part of the wave is constantly absorbed and interacts with the object of contact. Therefore, the object on which we are focusing our prayer on, in this case, my wife, that as an example I'm giving you now, is my object of focus. She is the person for whom I'm going to be doing this prayer. When I do this prayer, my thought wave, my sound waves are going to travel. It's going to clash with her. A part of it is going to reflect, refract, penetrate, and interact and absorbed by her. Now, therefore, there is every likelihood that if I send the right kind of wave towards her, that it is going to have the right kind of results for her, coupled, of course, with her own prayers and her own sadhana, and of course the miracles of the medicine and the various other treatment system that my son Dr. Achyutan Ishwar is giving her in the form of naturopathy and yoga techniques. Now, the prayer itself goes like this, just two words in Tamil: Valga Valamudan, Valga Valamudan, Valga Valamudan, வாழ்க வளமுடன். நவ் வாழ்க மீன்ஸ் பி லிவ், வளமுடன் மீன்ஸ் பி பிளெஸ்ட். நவ் தட்ஸ் அ சிம்பிள் டிரான்ஸ்லேஷன் ஆஃப் தமிழ் டு இங்கிலீஷ். நவ் வென் வி சே வாழ்க வளமுடன் இன் தமிழ், இஃப் யூ நோட்டிஸ் ட்வைஸ் தி டங் டச்சஸ் தி அப்பர் பேலட். வென் வி சே வாழ்க, த டங் டச்சஸ் தி அப்பர் பேலட் ஒன்ஸ் வென் வி சே வள முடன். வென் வி சே வள முடன், வென் வி சே, வென் வி சே த ல சவுண்ட், த டங் டச்சஸ் தி அப்பர் பேலட். Swamiji used to say that whenever the tongue touches the upper palate, the pituitary and pineal will get activated in the human brain, and there is every likelihood that the brain will start to function at the alpha level of frequency. You may have seen many videos or read many texts, and you may have even seen some of my videos that talk about the power of alpha level of frequency from the brain. And when we say this, when we recite this prayer, automatically an alpha wave emanates from our brain and goes towards the person that needs to be benefited from our prayer. You can say this in English, you can say this in Tamil, and I do this all the time. I repeat this several times. I do this first thing in the morning before I get out of the bed. I close my eyes, I think of my wife, I keep my mind at the Duriya Chakra. When I keep my mind on the alpha level at the Duriya Chakra, my automatically the brain calms down and an alpha wave emanates from my brain, and then I picture Valka Valamudan. Okay, now after I do my morning duties, I sit down and do my exercises, and when I meditate, I bless her a few more times. Then I do a special meditation for her called as the mirror gazing meditation. In the mirror gazing meditation, which is taught to you in the third level sky introspection workshop, allows you to increase your biomagnetic energy. And this is a form of healing process that is possible for a Kundalini yogi. When we do this meditation, after we finish this mirror gazing meditation, I look at her because I live with her in the house, and if I'm not there, if I'm traveling, I take a photograph of her with me and I look into her right eye in the photograph. Or when she is there in front of me, I look at her in your right eye and I imagine the life force traveling from my eyes into her eyes, and I say this prayer Valka Valamudan once again. I also continue to bless her, and I say it aloud that may the almighty divine force travel from my eyes into your eyes, and by the grace of the divine bliss, may you live in good health, long life, enough wealth, peace, prosperity, fame and wisdom, and completely heal yourself and be blessed. And I say this again and again, and when I say this as many times as I feel that I can sit and do it, I feel really great that I have done my little duty for her. Whatever karma that she is carrying, she has gotten this particular disease, but the doctors have told her that she is fit enough to get completely healed and cured very soon. I do hope that you also pray for your dear ones, for your loved ones, whether they have any kind of physical illness or mental problems or relationship problems or any other problems. Better still, if you continue to do this on a regular basis, perhaps you can also prevent problems for them. I wish you learn this miraculous prayers. There is no other prayer that is more powerful than this, according to our Guru Sri Vedatri Maharishi. And if you would like to learn more about this, do write to me at guru@simplifiedkundaliniyoga.com or do visit simplifiedkundaliniyoga.com. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel and put a comment on it. Every comment I reply. Be blessed by the divine.